We're back, so it must be Wednesday. I really cannot believe that it's Wednesday in September. But thank God that we've reached this point. And I want to show everyone, if anyone's watching, this thing. This is a telephone. So tomorrow, I would like every one of you who's watching this video to take your telephone and phone one person. Your neighbor, a friend, your relative who lives in China, or not China, Australia, Israel, anywhere, tell them you're thinking about them. We need to tell everyone that we are thinking about them, that we love them, our community in San Francisco, our community in Seattle, family in London, Israel, Venezuela, Los Angeles, New York. We have to tell them and to show them that we're thinking about them and we love them. So all of you who have a telephone at home, please use it tomorrow. Bye. Here's the rabbi.
And on that point, it's so nice to be able to talk with you again. You know, we know that the essence of Judaism is really to appreciate the kindness that God does with us, that and for us. That is really the essence. We are going to be reading Perashat Ki Tavo, and Ki Tavo, besides the fact that everybody relate to it as, you know, the parasha when there is the warning and the curses and so on, but the way it begins, the parasha, is something very beautiful. It is the mitzvah of Bikurim, the first fruit, and it begins by saying that Ki Tavo el Haaretz, when you come now, you have been preparing all this even 40 years, and now ultimately the promise is going to be fulfilled. You are going to come to Eretz Israel, to the land of Israel. And there, when you as a farmer, you are going to benefit and feel happy when you bring the produce, especially the first fruit. And then our rabbis tell us the declaration expresses something very unique and very very incredible, because the Torah says you have to make a declaration, a few verses that going to relate to your history, and that no matter whatever happened to you throughout your journey, ultimately you are getting there. And when you are getting there, you're going to be that farmer who is going to benefit from the land, and you're going to have the first fruit, and you're going to bring them to the Jerusalem, wherever you live, and to the Beit HaMikdash. And there, the elders of the cities are going to come and to welcome you in the procession that you are coming. And then they are going to welcome you and bring all this fruit, putting in the basket and give it to the temple and to the Kohanim. And it, with that declaration, you are going to say, thank you, God, that you brought me into the land and you kept your promise and you made me feel in practice and in person all the benefit of the land of Israel that you promised us. This is the Bikurim. And, you know, it was done with such fanfare, and everything is happy. Our rabbis only asked a question that it seems to be that we have got other offerings that have been brought throughout the year, even daily. And yet it's only this Bikurim is that there is so much fanfare and so many declarations that you have to do. Why it's so special? And not only that, there is a statement in the Talmud that tells that the entire universe, the world was created so that the mitzvah of Bikurim should be fulfilled. How come? What is it that our rabbis is telling us with that? Well, the point is that, you know, being a farmer, especially in those days, wasn't so easy. In fact, God praises Israel because it doesn't depend on a Nile like Egypt, but it depends on the rain, which means you are, as a farmer, you are are in doubt what's going to happen to all the work that you have throughout the year. And now you are trying and you are praying and you really direct your thought to God and you say, please make it possible and make it fruitful so that it should be, you know, sometimes it could be you have infestation, you can have monsoon, you can have so many things that can spoil everything. Ultimately, you come and get the first fruit and you're so happy. You know, the kind, it could be that a thought entered your mind, as the Torah said in Devarim later, sometimes you might say, Kochi ve'otzem yadi asali et achayil hazeh. My power and the strength of my hand what made me all this wealth. This is to take away that even thought, completely take away this thought from your mind and to realize and to let you know that everything is from HaKadosh Baruch Hu, from God, it's from His mercy, it's from Him. You are the benefactor of His kindness. And that is so, that's why Bikurim is such an incredible mitzvah. And our rabbi said is the essence of Judaism. Because the essence of Judaism, the worst thing that any person can be to God is being ungrateful. And the greatest thing is when you are grateful. And therefore this is for us, no matter whatever we are going through, everybody has ultimately, you reap the benefit and you get the greatness of what God gives you. You are the benefactor. And being a benefactor like that, you have to be grateful. And that's why the mitzvah of Bikurim, there is nothing like it. That's how the Torah begins, by saying, tell the story of what you went through, and ultimately, you are going to be a benefactor. God is looking after you, and no matter whatever the hiccups that you have, be always concentrating in that positive instead of the negative. So Shabbat Shalom, and I hope everybody has a wonderful
time. I forgot to mention our wonderful film crew, led by the producer and director, Michael Bihar, and his team. Thank you very, very much.